If you're using Python to automate making requests to web services and endpoints, chances are you're using Python's built-in libraries or third-party library like requests. Today, I'm going to demonstrate what, in my thoroughly biased opinion, is the best Python library right now for making web requests, HTTPX. And what makes HTTPX special? Three things. First, it's convenient. The syntax for making and processing requests is dead simple by default. Second, it's fully featured. Odds are you won't sacrifice any functionality by using it instead of another library. And finally, it's future-proof. It natively supports async, so you can use it with either synchronous or async code. So let's take a look at some simple examples of HTTPX in action. Here's what it looks like to make a simple GET request in HTTPX. It amounts to two lines, one of which is importing the library. And honestly, we spend more time doing things with the results than we do actually using the library to get the results. A result object gives us access to everything returned from the server, from the body of the request to the headers, formatted as a Python dictionary. If we want to post form data to an endpoint, we can also do that with very little boilerplate. In this example, I have my form data defined as a dictionary, and I just submit it along with my post request, like so. The same goes for doing things like multipart form uploads, submitting JSON form data, and so on. HTTPX also provides tools like providing timeouts for connections, which then raise an exception you can trap if needed. In this example, I have a default timeout set to 1 second, which has no trouble completing. But if I lower that to a fraction of a second, I get a timeout exception which I've trapped with my code. HTTPX also lets you set hooks for request and response events. In this example, I've created event hooks that fire before a request is placed and after it's returned. They're just functions that take the request or response objects as parameters, and the only requirement is that we perform our requests through a client object that uses them. Last but not least, everything I've shown here works whether you're using conventional synchronous programming or Python's async. Here's a short example of HTTPX's async support. The only major change is that we need to use an async version of the client object, and we use await with the methods on it. This context block, by the way, makes sure the client's resources are disposed of properly. But we don't want to use a pattern like this if we're performing many async connections at once. What we would do is create a single client object and then use multiple async requests with it. Here's a somewhat long-winded example of doing what I just described. Here I've created the async client, and I've used an async task group to run each of the client GET operations. The results all run asynchronously, and then I can parse each result object for the data produced by each request. What's key here is how the core behavior isn't very different. We're still using a GET method with a client object, we've just generated it and handled it a little differently. This makes it less difficult to take something synchronous and make it async later if we need to. Or, and this is the main thing, we can use HTTPX for both sync and async jobs side by side with similar syntax and conceits. That's really the big takeaway with using HTTPX. You have a simple interface for starters, which you can use synchronously. You don't have to do a lot of work to accomplish common tasks. Most of them can be done in one or two lines. And everything in HTTPX can work asynchronously too, with the core syntax for each method still being the same. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.